Sayın Valim, Sayın Büyükelçiler, Sayın Belediye Başkanlarım, Sayın Konsoloslar, kıymetli basın mensupları ve değerli misafirler.
Dear Governor, esteemed ambassadors, honorable mayors, distinguished consuls, respected members of the press and valued guests.
Beta Yenihan'da gerçekleştirdiğimiz Beta Uluslararası Çay ve Kültür Festivali resepsiyonuna hepiniz hoş geldiniz.
Welcome to the Beta International Tea and Culture Festival reception held at Beta Yenihan.
Bu özel günümüzde sizleri ağırlamaktan büyük onur duyuyoruz.
It is a great honor to host you on this special day.
Açılış konuşmasını yapmak üzere çay uzmanı Sayın Hatice Uğur'u kürsüye davet ediyorum.
To begin in the opening speech, I invite tea expert Ms. Hatice Uğur to the stage.
Sayın Valim, Sayın Büyükelçi, Sayın Konsoloslar, kıymetli konuklar ve değerli basın mensupları. Türkiye ve dünya çay sektörünün önce firmalarından Beta Çay olarak bu sene ilkini gerçekleştirdiğimiz Beta Uluslararası Çay ve Kültür Festivali resepsiyonuna hepiniz hoş geldiniz. 2019 yılında Birleşmiş Milletler tarafından kabul edilen 21 Mayıs Uluslararası Çay Günü dünya genelinde çayın tarihini, çeşitliliğini ve kültürel zenginliğini kutladığımız, aynı zamanda sürdürülebilirlik ve adil ticaret gibi önemli konulara dikkat çektiğimiz özel bir gündür. Tarihi 4000 yıl öncesine dayanan çay, dünyadaki en eski ve sudan sonra en çok tüketilen içecektir. 1924 yılında Rize'de üretimi başlayan Türk çayının bu sene 100. yılı olduğunu vurgulamak isteriz. Türkiye bugün dünyada en çok çay üreten 5. ülkedir. Aynı zamanda kişi başı yılda 3 kilogram tüketimle dünyada en çok çay içen ülke konumundayız. Türk çay kültürünün 2022 yılında UNESCO'nun somut olmayan kültürel miras listesine dahil edilmesiyle beraber dünyaca tanınmasının gururunu yaşıyoruz. Biz de Beta Çay olarak farklı coğrafyalarda Türk çayı ve dünya çaylarını tanıtan bir elçi niteliğinde bugünü sahiplendiğimiz için çok mutluyuz. İlk olarak 1987 yılında Sri Lanka'dan ithal ederek başladığımız çay yolculuğuna Türkiye, Hindistan, Çin ve Kenya başta olmak üzere bugün dünyada çay yetişen tüm ülkelerle ticarete devam etmekteyiz. Beta Çay dünyadaki 12. büyük çay firmasıdır. Türkiye'de Sanayi ve Teknoloji Bakanlığı'na bağlı çay alanında tek Ar-Ge merkezidir. Her bardak çayımızla uluslararası çay kültürünün tanıtılmasına katkı sağladığımıza inanıyoruz. Farklı ülkelerin çay kültürlerini daha yakından tanımak, zengin çay çeşitlerini, geleneksel demleme teknikleri ve ritüelleriyle deneyimlemek için bugün bir aradayız. Geleneksel çay seremonilerine Eyüp Kemal Sevinç Şef'in bugüne özel dünya çaylarını kullanarak hazırladığı çaylı lezzetler menümüz eşlik edecek. Bugün aramızda Arjantin, Bangladeş, Sri Lanka, Hindistan ve Çin büyükelçilikleri bulunmakta. Festivalimize katkıda bulunan tüm ülke temsilcilerine, bizleri yalnız bırakmadığınız için siz değerli misafirlerimize ve bugünü anlamlı kılan tüm çay severlere teşekkür ederiz. Beta Uluslararası Çay ve Kültür Festivali hafta boyunca çeşitli etkinliklerle Han'da devam ediyor olacak. Hepimize keyifli bir akşam dilerim.
Beta Gıda'nın tanıtım filmi sizlerle birlikte olacak.
Now, I present to you the promotional film of Beta Gıda.
Beta 1978'de filizlenen Beta Gıda, sadece çay sektöründe lider bir marka olmakla kalmayıp, aynı zamanda kalplerde yer alan bir değer haline geldi. Türkiye'ye ilk ithal ve bardak poşet çayı getirerek çay tutkunlarını yeniliklerle buluşturan Beta Gıda, çay severlerin odağı haline geldi. Sınırlarını aşarak Orta Asya ülkelerinde pazarın lider firmaları arasında yerini alırken, Amerika Birleşik Devletleri başta olmak üzere Avrupa ve diğer dünya ülkelerine de ulaştı. Beta Gıda, Sri Lanka Çay Borsası'nda en yüksek alım yapan firmalar arasında yerini aldı. 2014 Euro Monitör verilerine göre dünyanın en büyük 12. çay firması, Bayce markasıyla da dünyanın 3. yeşil çay markası olmayı başardı. Önce olduğu çay sektöründe ilk Ar-Ge merkezini 2018 yılında kurarak inovasyonlarla dolu ilklere imzasını attı. Karadeniz'in en kaliteli çay yaprakları özenle hasat edilerek Sürmene'de bulunan Beta Çay İşleme Fabrikası'nda Türk çayını uluslararası standartlarda insana ve doğaya duyulan sorumlulukla işlemektedir. Beta Tea Akademi, çay kültürünü, çay çeşitliliğini ve çay lezzetindeki farklılıkları anlamak ve geliştirmek isteyenler için fırsatlar sunmaya devam etmektedir. Mutluluk bir fincan çaydır. Anlayışı sunan Beta Tea House, çay tutkunlarına dünya çaylarını deneyimleme fırsatı sunar. Dünya çay kültürünü yansıtan aksesuar ve çeşitliliğiyle çayın büyülü dünyasına davet etmektedir. Beta Gıda, tarih ve kültüre saygı duyar ve geçmişten ilham alarak geleceği inşa etmeye inanır. İstanbul'da kahvenin ilk kavrulduğu fırının yer aldığı Emin Han, Tahmis Han ve Hasırcılar Han olarak bilinen Tarihi Han, 4 yıllık renovasyon sonrası 2019 yılında Beta Yeni Han olarak hizmete açılmıştır. Tarihi dokunun ve ihtişamın birleştiği Beta Yeni Han, İstanbul'un eşsiz uğrak noktalarından olmuştur. 1978'de filizlenen ve bugün kalplerde yer alan markalarından biri olmanın gururunu yaşayan Beta Gıda, heyecanını ilk günkü gibi taze tutuyor ve yaşamda iz bırakarak başarılı yolculuğuna devam ediyor. Beta Gıda.
Ünlü şef Eyüp Kemal Sevinç'in Uluslararası Çay Günü Festivali'ne özel hazırladığı Çaylı Füzyon Mutfağı'ndan çaylı lezzetlerin hikayesini anlatmak üzere kendisini sahneye davet ediyorum.
Now, I invite the renowned chef Eyüp Kemal Sevinç to the stage to share the story of the tea-infused delicacies he has specially prepared for the International Tea and Culture Festival reception.
Herkese iyi akşamlar, hepiniz hoş geldiniz. Beta Yeni Han'a. Hello everyone. Welcome to Beta Yeni Han. Tonight, what we will serve to you, I would like to explain the menu and how we combine this menu, which is most of the tea comes from our country. I make a fusion of that cultures, what we export from that countries to Turkey. I combine all these products and I make a special menu for that. First of all, I would like to explain what we serve first, sweet and sour snack plates. Gouda cheese and mushroom, which is marinated with Earl Grey tea and served with pesto dressing. And the second one mozzarella caprese bruschetta marinated with jasmine tea. And the third one, cheese and olives bruschetta with rooibos tea. And the last bruschetta is wheel jambon with asam masala. And then the sweet things, matcha macaron. I hope you like it. Colors is very nice. And what we serve with the chocolates, rooibos tea with white chocolate truffle. And the next one, bergamot with bitter truffle. And the cookies with matcha again, and some tartlets which you tasted with the red berries. The cream was matched with jasmine pearl. And what we will serve you for the cold canapés. The cold canapés will be hibiscus tea with vegetables wrapped with crepe and goat cheese. We are serving with cherry jelly and caramelized goat cheese. And the third one is with the masala tea jelly and grilled vegetables together with microgreens. And the fourth one, panna cotta with matcha served together with smoked salmon. The last one is tempura vegetables. We are serving on cauliflower puree together with butterfly tea. And for the hot starter, we will serve artichoke soup together with jasmine tea. And we will serve mantı cooked with Turkish tea, and will be served together yogurt sauce. And the third one, we will prepare peas and jasmine pearl basmati, serve it with veal filet. And the fourth one, we will serve Indian rice with masala tea and grilled chicken. And the last hot starter is we will serve salmon, grilled salmon, serve it with potato puree, mix it with matcha tea. Yes, this is the menu. I hope you will like it. I hope you will remember in your mouth taste, this tastes, and have a lovely evening. Thank you very much. Bon appétit.
Tamam. Sayın Eyüp Kemal Sevince, güzel lezzetleri ve çaylı mutfaktan füzyonla beraber harmanladığı lezzetler için kendisine teşekkür ederiz. Karadeniz çayının ezgilerini içeren kemence ve tulum dinletisi sizlerle birlikte olacak.
Enjoy the melodies of the Black Sea Tea with a performance of kemence and tulum.
Karadeniz çayının ezgileri sizlerle birlikte oldu. Şimdi sırada çay demleme şampiyonu Gül Hanım Deli Hasan eşliğinde Türk çay seremonisi sizlerle birlikte olacak.
We will now join the Turkish tea culture ceremony led by Turkey's tea brewing champion Miss Gül Hanım Deli Hasan.
Ses. Tamam. Biraz daha aşağı inirsek.
Tamam. Başka ayak var mı?
Tamam. Buradan da Şu masa üstü mikrofonu da verseniz. Herkese mikrofonu açalım. Tamam, sadece de çayı demlerken ben sizden yardım isteyeceğim. Herkese merhabalar, hoş geldiniz. Rize'den size kucak dolusu sevgiler getirdim, selamlar getirdim. Bugün size siyah Türk çayını demleyeceğim. Demleme tekniklerini göstereceğim. Ayrıca Türk çayı ile ilgili birkaç dipnot vereceğim. Camellia sinensis Türkiye'de en uzun karda beslenen bir çaydır. Türkiye'de çok farklı tekniklerle üretilse de dünyada en çok tüketilen su kadar içtiğimiz bir çaydır. Ben size Mayıs ayında bütün kış kar altında beslenmiş çayı şimdi nasıl demleyeceğimi göstereceğim. Öncelikle alt demlikteki suyumuzu kaynatıyoruz. Sonra alt demlikteki kaynar suyu bol oksijenle buluşturarak üst demliğimize döküyoruz. Burada oksijenle buluşturmamızın çok önemli bir sebebi var. Çayın tadımını ve kalitesini artıran bir etkendir bu. Bakır demlik neden kullanıyorum? Biz Türkler çayı sıcak içmeyi sevdiğimiz için kullanıyoruz. Sonrasında siyah çayımı koyduğum kaynar suyun üzerine ilave ediyorum. 5 kişilik bir aileyiz biz. O yüzden 5 kişilik bir aile için 5 kaşık çayımızı ilave ettikten sonra 15 dakika demlenmesini bekliyoruz. Burada çayı neden üstten koyduk? Çayımız alt demlikteki su kaynadıkça üst demlikteki çayımız yavaş yavaş çöke demini ve rengini vere demlenmiş olur. Teşekkür ediyorum beni dinlediğiniz için. Herkese hoş geldin tekrar.
Türkiye Çay Demleme Şampiyonu Gül Hanım Deli Hasan'a teşekkür ederiz. Şimdi sırada elçiliklerin özel seremoni gösterileri var.
Next, we have specialty ceremony presentations from the embassies.
Arjantin Başkonsolos Yardımcısı Fabiana Lopez'i konuşmasını yapmak üzere sahneye davet ediyorum.
I invite Deputy Consul General of Argentina, Ms. Fabiana Lopez, to give her speech.
Just one moment. Teşekkürler. Good evening. Aga. Ay. Baş.
Well, thank you for coming to all. I am the Deputy Consul of Argentina. Here with me is Ariana. It's an Argentine citizen living in Turkey, married with a Turkish. She will help with the ritual of mate. I will say a few words first about this beverage. It is our national infusion declared in 2013 by law, Argentina National Infusion, and we celebrate on November 30 the National Day of Mate, always also established by law. The most important feature of mate is that it is a beverage to share. It is a beverage which calls to meetings. In Argentina, when we say let's have some mates, it means we go on talking, we go on meeting. It is for friends, for families. Mate is a beverage that unites all social classes, all young people, old people, in other times, people from different social classes, like masters and slaves, all were united by mate. Now she will explain the ceremony, but mate is consumed in Argentina 80% as a hot mate. This is the mate that Ariana will prepare, the main mate, 80%. Then we have 48% tea, 44% coffee consumption, I mean in Argentina. And then with lower values, we have 29% cooked mate, which here it is called mate chai infusion. It is prepared in bags, like tea with hot, with boiling water, and cooked mate with 12% cooked mate made directly with yerba mate put in the water, and then passed through a strainer. She will explain the ceremony, and perhaps I made some comment too. I will, as I have the microphone here, I will help with the comments. The first step. To make a good mate, 6 steps are required. The first one is three quarters of the container. The container itself is called mate, the same as the beverage. Mate is the beverage and mate is the container. So 3/4 of the container of the mate are filled with yerba. It's what Ariana will do now. Ya está. Then the container, the mate, is shaked off, put in the palm of the hand on the mouth of the mate. Eso. Ya está, ya shaked. All the yerba, all the herb, is put in one side of the container, so that when the container is placed upright, the yerba remains obliquely placed. Do you understand? Do you understand? You can take a look. You can get closer to take a look. Ah, here. Okay. Sigo. Well, the fourth step. A splash of cold or mild water is poured into the container, into the part of the mate where there is less yerba. Ya está, ¿no? Ah, no. Then, after doing this, when the yerba swells, the straw is placed right there, in the place where the yerba swells. The mate is prepared, pouring water, hot water, not boiling, as close as the straw as possible, to avoid wetting all the yerba. In this way, the mate will retain longer its flavor, and with every pouring, every time we pour water to make a new mate, the yerba will release its flavors. If we do different and all the yerba were wet, the mate becomes washed. It is called in Argentina washed. Washed, it is not nice. It is it loses the taste. Do you understand? Finally, it is recommended not to move the straw once the mate is started, so that it does not get blocked and the dry yerba does not become wet. So this is done with keeping the straw without moving it the less as possible. I think you understood this, but the fact is that mate is a shared beverage. I mean, in Argentina, for example, in Syria, the mate is well extended in Syria because of the great Syrian immigration that we had in Argentina. But in Syria, where I had lived for 2 years and a half until recently, mate is individual. So in Syria, each people has its mate, its own mate with its own straw. But in Argentina, it's a shared beverage. So there is a round of people, each one has a mate, so, and then passes to the neighbor, and so on. Do you understand? So it is a shared beverage. Now she will show the cooked mate. Cooked mate is the variation which you can drink as tea. Some people here has tasted in our place as tea. They are the yerba is put in bags, and then boiling water is poured, and you can enjoy cooked mate. And cooked mate can be made too directly with yerba, so not in bags, but then it has to be strained with a strainer. So here we have the version of cooked mate in bags. It is not so consumed in Argentina as the first mate, the mate to share, the hot mate. There is another kind of mate. It is called tereré. It is cold mate. So the same as Ariana has explained, but instead of putting hot water with cold water, between 5 and 8 degrees centigrade. It is above all in the northeast of Argentina, in Misiones, where the yerba mate is grown, when it is very hot in summer, tereré, o sea, cold mate, is drunk. Okay, it's all. Teşekkürler.
Masayı alın.
Ben biraz zaman
Çin Büyükelçiliği Kültür Müsteşarı Sayın Meifeng Zhao'yu konuşmasını yapmak üzere sahneye davet ediyorum. Ardından Çin Kung Fu Tea Show sizlerle birlikte olacak.
I invite Mr. Meifeng Zhao, Cultural Counselor of the Chinese Embassy, to give his speech. Following his speech, we will have the Chinese Kung Fu Tea Show.
Okay, and dear General Manager and Ambassador and distinguished guests and friends, good evening. Malabar. I'm very happy to participate in the celebration of International Tea Day hosted by the Beta Gita Company. So China is a hometown of tea. The Chinese have used tea as medicine and food for more than 4,000 years. In the Tang Dynasty, more than 1,400 years ago, tea began to become a popular drink among Chinese people. Since its development, China has a wide variety of teas and exquisite productions. Different regions and ethnic groups have formed rich and diverse tea drinking habits and customs. Tea is a part of Chinese life. Tea is a daily necessity for Chinese people, and it's also a living habit and a way of life. The soul of Chinese tea ceremony is harmony, so which means openness and tolerance, advocating the harmony of China and the unity of nature and man. It can be said that Chinese tea culture contains the common values and the moral norms of the Chinese nation. Today, Chinese people pay attention to healthcare, happiness, culture, and other functions when drinking tea, giving the tea more connotations such as health preservation, self-cultivation, and making friends. In 2022, so China's tea making skills and related customs and the Turkey's tea culture is a symbol of identity, hospitality, and the social interaction were included in the UNESCO representative list of a human intangible cultural heritage, becoming a common heritage for all mankind. Tea is a link and bridge connecting China and the world. Since more than 2,000 years ago, tea has been an important commodity in Sino-foreign trade, passing through the Silk Road, the Asian tea horse road, accompanied by camel bells, Chinese tea, traveled across the ocean, took root all over the world, and integrated in social life, forming a rich and diverse world tea culture, each with its own beauty. Currently, more than 60 countries and regions produce tea in the world, and nearly 3 billion people drink tea in more than 160 countries and regions. Tea and tea culture are precious gifts that China has given to the world. With their rich material and spiritual values, they have promoted exchanges and mutual learning among human civilizations. Finally, I wish everyone a happy tea tasting and complete success of the event. Thank you very much. Teşekkür ederiz.
Beyza Hanım. Sri Lanka Büyükelçisi Sayın Hasanti Dissanayake'yi konuşmasını yapmak üzere sahneye davet ediyorum. Ardından Sri Lanka'nın geleneksel kıyafet şovu gösterisi ve yakma seremonisi sizlerle birlikte olacak.
I invite Ambassador of Sri Lanka, Ms. Hasanti Dissanayake, to give her speech. Following her speech, we will have the traditional attire show and the oil lamp ceremony.
Excellencies, Mr. Ali Ur from Beta T, and also the President of Turkey Sri Lanka Business Council, Mrs. Hatice Ur, Director Beta T in Istanbul, Mr. Aydin Uzu, Honorary Consul for Sri Lanka in Istanbul, Kiriklareli, Sakarya, and Yalova, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Subha Sandhyavak, Malai Vanakkam, good evening, E. Akshamla. It is indeed my pleasure to join the International Tea Day 2024 celebrated in Istanbul. The resolution on International Tea Day was adopted on 21st December 2019 by the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization. The International Tea Day serves as a poignant reminder of the profound cultural and economic impact of tea on societies across the globe. The goal of the day is to promote and foster collective actions to implement activities in favor of the sustainable production and consumption of tea and raise awareness of its importance in fighting hunger and poverty. As the world commemorates the International Tea Day today, Ceylon tea stands proudly at the forefront, celebrating rich heritage, unparalleled quality, and global significance. Renowned for its unique flavor profile and exquisite aroma, Ceylon tea has captivated enthusiasts worldwide for generations. Originating from the lush hillside of Sri Lanka, this beloved brew continues to enchant connoisseurs and novices alike, embodying a tradition of excellence spanning nearly two centuries. This year's focus will shine a spotlight on women in the tea sector, highlighting their rich and diverse contributions across the supply chain from the crop to a cup. Early today, Sri Lanka Tea Board launched an event in Colombo, which was also streamed online to celebrate tea culture, highlighting the role of women in the industry, particularly in the developing world. Out of the script, I want to bring your attention to all the posters that you have around here from all the countries. Whom you see in the pictures are mostly women. So when we drink tea, remember that it comes from very dedicated women who pick tea. So this is the focus of Sri Lanka celebrating tea today. Beta Tea, organizers of this event in Istanbul to celebrate this special day, is a pioneering tea company in Turkey and is the first company in modern times to start importing tea from Sri Lanka. And my heartfelt thanks go to Beta Tea for organizing this beautiful event. Today, Ceylon tea is considered as Sri Lanka's gift to the world. Sri Lanka was formerly a British Crown colony known as Ceylon, a name it kept for nearly a quarter a century after independence. For those who do not know much about Sri Lanka, it is a green and lushy, fertile tropical island in the Indian Ocean, just below the southeastern tip of India. It is about 1/12 of Turkey in terms of land area. Now let me share with you the fascinating story of Ceylon tea. Will you believe that the story of Ceylon tea begins with coffee? The tale begins in early 1820s, barely 5 years after the Kingdom of Kandy was surrendered to the British after signing the Kandyan Convention. Experiments with coffee had already begun by 1824, when coffee cultivation was seen as a solution to the colony's perennial balance of payment problem. The plant had already been found growing naturally among the approaches to the central hills of the country, and the colonial government promoted large-scale coffee cultivation. By 1870, Sri Lanka became the world's largest producer of coffee.
Profits and revenue generated by coffee trade turned the country into an imperial showpiece for the British, prosperous, civilized, and modern. This glory was short-lived. In 1869, there were first signs of a plant disease. The blight took slightly more than a decade to wipe out the entire coffee industry in Ceylon. Let's now turn to try and understand how tea became synonymous with Sri Lanka. The first tea plant was brought to Sri Lanka from China and was planted in the Royal Botanical Gardens in Peradeniya for non-commercial purposes. In 1852, a Scottish gentleman, James Taylor, arrived in Sri Lanka and he was made the manager of Lul Kondera Estate, a coffee plantation. The owners of the plantation started encouraging this manager to experiment with tea, and by some years later, 2 years before the blight of the coffee came, already by 1872, there was a sale of tea in candy, and it was going to UK at that time. Hence, James Taylor is considered as the father of Ceylon tea. Tea from our country soon gained reputation of being the finest in the world, and tea exports became the mainstay of the economy. In 1965, Sri Lanka became, for the first time, the world's largest exporter of tea. When the country changed its name from Ceylon to Sri Lanka in 1972, it continued with the Ceylon tea name, as the brand Ceylon tea and its lion logo was already known to consumers from Virginia in the US to Vladivostok in the Soviet Union at that time. Let us now consider some of the unique places that Sri Lanka has in the world tea. In terms of export value in the world, in 2023, Sri Lanka ranks second after China with exports of 255 million kilograms of a value of US$1.3 billion. Our top five buyers include Iraq, Russian Federation, UAE, of course, Turkey, and Iran. The Earl Grey tea of ours is enjoyed at the Buckingham Palace, and it's of pure Ceylon tea origin. We also supply tea to Olympic and Commonwealth Games. We are the first country to achieve the ozone-friendly tea in the world. Our tea is also considered as cleanest, as confirmed by the International Standards Organization. Our famous lion logo on your tea pack indicates that it's 100% Ceylon tea packed in Sri Lanka. And if it is not, that means whoever who is doing that is violating the law. Ceylon tea's lion logo is registered in over 100 countries, including in Turkey. Our tea is hand-picked, and the industry is considered as ethical. Tea processing in Sri Lanka includes the steps of plucking of the two leaves and the bud. Then it is go through a processing called withering, rolling, fermentation, firing, sorting, and then there is bulk packing, or it's packed for different brands. Ceylon tea is graded into different categories based on the size and the shape of the tea leaf. There are two main categories of our tea, whole leaf grade and broken leaf. Within the main categories, there are rejected parts, which are called fannings, expensive flowery grades, then whole leaf grades and broken tea grades. Then, of course, there are flavors based on which region the tea comes from. Some regions are very hilly, some regions are more moist, some are dry, some are close to the sea. So the seven regions are Nuwara, Udupuzzalava, Uwa, Dimbula, Kandy, Sabaragamuwa, and Ruhura. We also do green tea, and the main difference when making green tea is the oxidization process is omitted, which allows the tea to remain green in color and very delicate in flavor. We also have organic teas and value-added teas, including various types of instant teas, bio teas, flavored teas, iced tea, tea cordial, and a whole range of herbal teas. When benefits of tea are considered, research has shown that tea drinking could
reduce the risk of heart disease. Tea polyphenols could help in reducing the initiation and progression of some cancers, reducing cholesterol and blood clotting. Tea is also a good source of fluoride. And also, Ceylon black tea contains less caffeine than coffee and is an excellent booster for your immune system. And I also recall during the COVID, a lot of people started drinking tea because it gives the opportunity to reduce some of the symptoms. What makes Ceylon tea, which is not native to Sri Lanka, unique, is the water, soil and its minerals, and the tropical weather that nourishes the tree plants, which cannot be replicated elsewhere. Then again, even the tea produced in Sri Lanka will not taste the same elsewhere in the world. The water with which you prepare the tea to drink makes a whole lot of a difference. So if you want to drink Ceylon tea and feel how it is in a very different way, you need to visit Sri Lanka. So when you drink the same tea in Sri Lanka, in Turkey, in UK, in Georgia, in USA, same tea pack will taste differently. It's because of the water. To Turkey, due to high taxes, only certain types of tea comes as bulk tea. Of course, you also find kaçak çay in the eastern parts of Turkey, so some people get to enjoy that as well. On the other hand, the story of Ceylon is an example of how Sri Lanka's development trajectory evolved as a result of British colonization, showcasing resilience and adaptability of its people in the face of challenges. Thank you all for your attention and participation in this celebration of World Tea, at which I could share you the rich heritage of Ceylon tea. As we conclude, I would like to highlight the significance of the lighting of the oil lamp, which you can see in the middle. It's a tradition deeply rooted in the Sri Lankan culture. This ritual marks the beginning of any special event, symbolizing blessings and auspiciousness. In keeping with this tradition, I extend warm invitation for the gracious participation of esteemed special guests, including the governor of Istanbul, who is present here with us today. And again, I thank everyone. Teşekkürler.
Şimdi Sri Lanka'nın kıyafet gösterisi sizlerle birlikte olacak.
We will have the traditional attire show now. Langa madavatena urupema ka patalena uwanari manhari sukumali numbatama italanga madavatena urupema ka patalena uwanari manhari sukumali numbatama manike mage hite
itinepa matana wangu gatte hita numba mage mahengu alenu patama walangu manike wenna patawa sunangu Kame kata karma kella hita velanu beruwata bill netin neta gatama alla mage hitat naha matama mella kelle kelle vela mage hita pattu vena wata tava tika kittu mata pissu tad vena vidiyata gassu oya dunna ingiyata mattu bambareki mama tatu issu oya wata karagena rasu rotten hita ara gattu bambara
Talanga madavatena urupemaka patalena uwanari manhari sukumali numbatama talanga madavatena urupemaka patalena
Sri Lanka'nın geleneksel yağ yakma seremonisi için
For the oil lamp ceremony.
Sayın Hatice Uğur'u, Sayın Mehmet Ali Uğur'u, Sayın Şevket Atlı'yı
Mr. Jinkeba, Mr. Rodrigo Lopez, Miss Ariana Forte, Miss Ines de Sanayaka, Mr. Meifen Zhao, Mr. Pingmen Shen, Miss Fabiana Lopez, we kindly invite you to our stage for the oil lamp ceremony. Mr. Meifen Zhao. Yeah. Mr. Pingmen Shen.
Burada.
Miss Fabiana Lopez. Miss Fabiana Lopez. We kindly invite you to our stage.
Thank you.
Değerli misafirlerimiz, bu özel günü bizimle paylaştığınız için teşekkür ederiz. Önümüzdeki yıllarda da birlikte Beta Uluslararası Çay ve Kültür Festivali ile bu anlamlı günü yaşatmaya devam eder. Geldiğiniz için tekrar teşekkür ederiz. İyi akşamlar.
Dear guests, thank you for sharing this special day with us. We look forward to continuing to celebrate this meaningful day with the Beta International Tea and Culture Festival in the coming years. Thank you once again for joining us, and I wish you all a pleasant evening.